Hello there. I'm Green Deane, and welcome back to my 21st video here on EatTheWeeds.com, and today we're going to be talking about a prime foraging food. It's called the Cnidocolis stimulosus. Now, try saying that one 10 times fast. In fact, try saying that 3 times fast. It's called the Spurge Nettle, even though it's not a spurge, and it's not a nettle, but it's a prime root that you can go out there and get year-round. I think it tastes like pasta. Above the ground, it will sting the heck out of you. Below the ground, it'll feed you. So let's take a look at it, then we'll go out in the field, dig one up, maybe cook it, and then we'll come back and itemize it, and you'll learn a lot more about the Cnidocolis stimulosus. Well, that's what we're looking for right there, public edible number one. That's a Cnidocolis stimulosus, or spurge nettle. Notice it's got leaves that are 3 or 5 lobes to them. They're uneven, and it's kind of shiny. It's got some spots on it. But it also has got a heck of a lot of little hairs on them, plus on the stem, and actually the stinging hairs are also on the petals of the flowers as well. The entire plant above ground, you don't touch. And it's growing in the environment it likes to grow in, which is kind of a dry area with a bit of grass. Now, let's go out and check it out in the field. Dig one up.
Well, that's where you got yourself off to. I was wondering, you know, you shouldn't go running around spurge nettle country on your own. You might get stung. Oh, you don't think so? Well, let me show you. There's a spurge nettle right there. So we're going to dig this one up, and let me show you the right way to dig it up. Most people start digging here. I'm going to start digging over here. So why don't you go have a seat, and I'll take care of it. Okay, now I want you to listen. I'm getting a little tired doing all the work around here, right? All you do is sit around and watch me. So you're gonna go down this hole and you're gonna scope out the Cnidocolis root. You all set? Let's go do it. Now, can you see it? What do you see? After all, what's down there? Oh, a small Cnidocolis root, a small spurge nettle root. Okay, we'll dig on a bigger plant next time, but okay, that's where it is. Now, get up here before you get the bends. All set? Okay, come on. Well, here we are in Green Deane's kitchen, and here's the root that I dug up this morning. Now, I put the camera down inside the hole for you to see where the root was in relationship to the ground. Most people, when they start to dig these roots up, start digging right where the plant is. And what happens is in the first, you know, half a dozen, a dozen shovelfuls, they actually throw the root away. Then all what they see is this part here, because the top part's been tossed away and it's actually underneath the pile of dirt. So they keep following this little root here and keep digging and digging. They dig down 3 feet. Sometimes one fellow said he dug down 12 feet. And he said, I never found the root. Well, the reason why he didn't find the root was it was on the top of the ground, buried underneath all that dirt. It's never been in my experience that these roots are buried deep. They're always within a foot of the surface, right directly below the plant. That's why you have to start digging off to the side, and then you shave your way over after you've got a hole that's about a foot to 14 inches deep. It's not that difficult. Now, what I'm going to do today is take this root and some others down here that I went over and got another plant and dug it up. You can see how brittle it is. It came out in 5 or 6 pieces. And I'll boil them for about 20 minutes and then rice them or butter them, but I'll show you the core in the middle. And then, down the hatch. So let's cook them up. Now, no matter how much you cook a spurge nettle, it's always going to have a bit of tooth, like a slightly hard macaroni. And this morning I had the luck of the draw. I dug up 2 plants. I dug up a young one and an old one, and so I didn't get one in the middle. That's usually about the size of a carrot, a little longer. But you can also see here, it peels just very much like a potato, quite easily. And what we'll do now is, and right here actually is the cord. There's a cord right here. And I'm not sure I can pull it out this way. So normally what you have to do is split the root down the middle. And it sometimes objects to that. Get the cord out that way. And you can see the cord coming out now. It's right here. Here's the cord we get rid of. And it's a nice little tough piece right there, several little pieces of it. And once you get that done, you then
simply, and it's amazingly tough. Then you can either rice it or just chop it up and put some butter on it, which is how I like it. And that is, delicious.
Here on EatTheWeeds.com, we itemize, so I-T-E-M, item. So the first one is going to be identification. Spurge Nettle is palmate. It has either 3 to 5 lobes on it. They're irregular, and the leaves are covered with little tiny stinging hairs. Now, you should be able to identify it without touching it, but if you need to identify it, you can touch it, but I won't recommend it. And the burn will last for about an hour. So after identification, we have time of year. The Spurge Nettle is available year-round, which makes it a prime foraging food because no matter what the weather, you can always find a meal. And next is environment. The Spurge Nettle likes it dry. It likes sandy areas, old fields, roadsides, dunes, scrub pines, any place like that. That's, you won't find it in a wet spot whatsoever. Also, when it comes to environment, when you're working on one plant, make sure that you've got the other ones around. There are other ones. They grow in clumps. My point is, if you're working one plant, you can easily get stung by another. So make sure when you're working on this not to bump into another plant, because it will bother you for an hour or so, or at least it bothers me for an hour. And so after that, we have method of preparation. I've always boiled mine. I kind of break them up into little pieces because the plant comes out brittle anyways. The roots are rather brittle, so it breaks up, and I simply boil it. And then I take off the peeling and cut it. There's a cord that runs through it that's not edible. And when I say it's not edible, it's just too tough. And you might be able to use it for quarters. You take that out, then you mash it or rice it, and makes it wonderful. Put some butter and some salt and pepper on it, and off you go. By now, I hope you're rooting for Sinaita scolyus stimulosus, because if there's one near you, you'll always have something to eat. Now remember, in the hierarchy of foraging, roots provide the most nutrition, nut meats the second, fruits the third, and then of course vegetation last. So that's a good reason to know the edible roots that are near your area, and the good way to know those is, as I've said before, check with your local expert. Now I want to thank you for joining me on my 21st video here at EatTheWeeds.com, and visit the site EatTheWeeds.com. I've got blogs there on about close to 100 plants and several videos, so I think you'll learn a lot and enjoy it. So until our next plant, I'm Green Deane. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green. And that sometimes includes a carrot sausage-like brown pasta-tasting root called Sinaita scolyus stimulosus. Enjoy it. Toodles.